Hey, boys and girls, it's Monday morning. It's Mr. Jackson. I'm coming to you today. It's Monday morning. I'm coming on to you, even though I'm rocking my Dallas Cowboy jersey, even though we lost yesterday. But you know what? You know what made me losing so I'm still so happy? Because the Washington team lost yesterday. And as long as Washington lost, I'm okay with our loss yesterday. But you know what? Hey, I'm still a diehard Cowboys fan, rocking this jersey that actually, believe it or not, a student bought this jersey for me a few years ago as a gift. And I've been rocking this jersey ever since. So, but anyhow, I want to talk to you today about identity. And we're going to talk about our identity and who we are and why we are. Because and you're like, what does that got to do with Native Americans? Well, I'm gonna break that down for you in just the next 3 minutes here. I want you today to discover who you are and why you're the person that you are. What are those unique qualities about you that make who you are? Isn't it interesting that you are being taught by a history teacher from the great state of Texas, who is a Dallas Cowboy fan, and Dallas is in what state? Texas. And I'm not actually from Dallas. I actually grew up in Austin, Texas. Now, if you know anything about Austin, we have a saying in Austin, keep Austin weird. That's the city's motto. Keep Austin's weird. If you look it up and you're like, what does that mean? It's just, that's their motto. They've been always an out of the box, out of the thinking type city. Well, guess what? You have an out of the box, weird history teacher. I like to do things out of the box. Nothing ordinary with Mr. Jackson at all. But that's a tie to my identity. Look at all of that. I'm a Dallas Cowboy fan. I'm from Texas and I'm weird. I'm Austin, Texas, which is a weird city. Look at how that has come full circle, how all of that has worked out for who I am as an individual. That's part of my identity. So today I want you to think about what makes your identity, what makes you special, what makes you who you are. You're like, well, what does that got to do with Native Americans, Mr. Jackson? Well, I want you to think about Native Americans' identity was clearly tied into the land in which they lived on. And they were interchangeable. They looked at the land and man as one because they saw so much. Remember, we talked about how they used everything in nature, everything in environment for their living. And so that's why when we get about 2 or 3 weeks from now, we'll be talking about the European explorers. When they came in, they saw the land as just something you could claim. The Native Americans didn't see that. They saw the land as something to be cherished, something to be worshipped, something to be prized, not something that you just put a flag down and say, hey, this is my land. They didn't look at it in those terms. And so I want you to think about, well, what makes you unique? What makes you who you are? You know, one of the things I love about is not only that I'm a Dallas Cowboy fan, but my favorite food is I got two. I love Mexican food and I love barbecue. I love both of those. You ever talk about Mexican food and you ever talk about barbecue, you're gonna make Mr. Jackson mad because that's tied to my identity. Why? Because in the great state of Texas, we're so close to Mexico. We have a great Tex-Mex type food, Mexican food abundance. Now, every street you go down in Austin, Texas, in that whole region, Mexican restaurants on every corner, and you can get some of the best tasting Mexican food that you've ever had in the United States. Same thing. I think the only other state that comes close to us is California. And then the second thing is barbecue. I don't care what nobody says. I'm partial. I don't like that Tennessee barbecue or that North Carolina barbecue. And we're not going to talk about Virginia and how nasty their barbecue is. All right. But Texas, barbecue there is a cuisine. And it's a tie to my identity. When my friends and I are going out to eat, they're like, well, what want to eat? They're like, well, they already know what Jackson wants to eat. Mr. Jackson wants to eat barbecue or Mexican food because those are my two favorite types of food. But it's tied to my identity. It's who I am. And so today, I want you to think about it. I want to take a look at something. Look at these two aliens. If they came down from the sky above and they looked and said, are you able to tell me exactly who you are? Would you be able to tell an alien other than your name and that you're a human being who you are? Would you be able to tell that alien what makes you who you are? You're like, what am I talking? What are you talking about, Mr. Jackson? Things like, would you be able to tell the alien your habits, some of your appearances, some of your values and beliefs, things that you believe in, some of your interests, some of your family and friends, your hobbies, your foods, your dislikes, your likes, things that make you mad, things that make you happy, things that you've done over you that have created the very person that you are. You know, what can you tell that alien about who you are as a person, that when they walk off from you, they can say he or she has a habit of studying all night long. He or she has a habit of caring for others, or seeing to the sick, or you have a belief that, you know, used to take care of your neighbor or to see after your neighbor. What, you know, what can you tell that alien about you? So today, I want you, when you there's a discussion question that you're going to be have to answer, and it's going to ask you what be able to describe who you are as a person. I want you to be able to answer, and I put some of those same little bullet points I just had up. I put some of those there for you to go over, and I want you to write out, and I want you to be descriptive. Please don't just give me like one answer, one statement answers. Be descriptive. I want to know who you are. I want you to see like who the Native, because as we work through this, I want you to see this with Native Americans. So on Tuesday, when we come to class, we're going to talk about this, and then we're going to see how Native Americans and who they were and how they were tied to the land. Okay. All right. So, and then also, you're going to also do a newsletter article. Many of you should already know how to do Newsela. Go in there and take do your Newsela article, and take the quiz. I will be checking that to see what you're doing, and that you're spending some time in there. Read those articles. I gave some options to do, and it's pretty cool. You're gonna like the three articles that I chose for you. Okay. All right. This is Mr. Jackson. That's my time. Y'all have a great day, and I'll see you on Tuesday. Thank you. Take care now. Bye-bye.